वेदसार शिवस्तोत्रम्। पशूनां पतिं पापनाशं परेशं गजेन्द्रस्य कृत्तिं वसानं वरेण्यं जटाजूटमध्ये स्फुरद्गांगवारिं महादेवमेकं स्मरामि स्मरारिम्। महेशं सुरेशं सुरारातिनाशं विभुं वेश्वनाथं विभूत्यंगभूषं विरूपाक्षमिन्द्वर्कवह्नी त्रिनेत्रं सदानंदमीडे प्रभुं पंचवक्त्रम्। गिरीशं गणेशं गले नीलवर्णं गवेन्द्रादिरूढं गुणातीतरूपं भवं भास्वरं भस्मनाभूषिताङ्गं भवानीकलत्रं भजे पंचवक्त्रम्। शिवाकांत शंभो शशांकार्धमौले महेशानशूलिन् जटाजूटधारिन् त्वमेको जगत्व्यापको विश्वरूप प्रसीद प्रसीद प्रभो पूर्णरूप। परात्मानमेकं जगद्बीजमाद्यं निरीहं निराकार ओंकार वेद्यं यतो जायते पाल्यते येन विश्वं तमीशं भजे लीयते यत् विश्वम्। न भूमिर्न चापो न वह्निर्न वायुः न चाकाशमास्ते न तन्द्रा न निद्रा न चोष्णं न शीतं न देशो न वेशो न यस्यास्ति मूर्तिस्त्रिमूर्तिं तमीडे। अजं शाश्वतं कारणं कारणानां शिवं केवलं भासकं भासकानां तुरीयं तमः पारमाद्यन्तहीनं प्रपद्ये परं पावनं द्वैतहीनम्। नमस्ते नमस्ते विभो विश्वमूर्ते नमस्ते नमस्ते चिदानंदमूर्ते नमस्ते नमस्ते तपोयोगगम्य नमस्ते नमस्ते श्रुतिज्ञानगम्य। प्रभो शूलपाणे विभो विश्वनाथ महादेव शंभो महेश त्रिनेत्र शिवाकांत शांत स्मरारे पुरारे त्वदन्यो वरेण्यो न मान्यो न गण्यः। शंभो महेश करुणामय शूलपाणे गौरीपते पशुपते पशुपाशनाशिन् काशीपते करुणया जगदेतदेकः त्वं हंसि पासि विदधासि महेश्वरोऽसि। त्वत्तो जगद्भवति देव भवस्मरारे त्वय्येव तिष्ठति जगन्मृड विश्वनाथ त्वय्येव गच्छति लयं जगदेतदीश लिंगात्मके हरचराचर विश्वरूपिन लिंगात्मके हरचराचर विश्वरूपिन। इति वेदसार शिवस्तोत्रम्। श्री गणेशाय नमः। ओम श्री सरस्वत्यै नमः। ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। ओम समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं। ओम श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पाद शंकरं लोकशंकरं। ओम कर्पूर गौरम करुणावतारम संसार सारम भुजगेन्द्रहारम सदा वसंतम हृदयारविंदे भवम भवानी सहितम नमामि। हरि ओम। मंत्र श्लोक नंबर 3। गिरीशम गणेशम गले नीलवर्णम गवेन्द्राधिरूढ़ गुणातीत रूपम भवम भास्वरम भस्मनाभूषितांगम भवानी कलत्रम भजे पंचवक्त्रम। टुडे वी हैव टू सी दिस भस्मना भूषितांगम। भगवान शिवजीज शरीर इज बॉडी इज अडोर्ड स्मियर्ड बट अडोर्न्ड विथ व्हाट आई कॉल भस्म। डायरेक्ट मीनिंग ऑफ द वर्ड भस्म इज ऐश एशेस। वी विल फाइंड ओनली दिस लॉर्ड शिवा इज अडोर्न्ड विथ दिस एशेस। इन वन ऑफ द उपनिषद्स नॉट ऑफ दिस मेजर 11 उपनिषद बट अदर उपनिषद इट इज सेड there are 5 names for bhasma, for the ashes. One is vibhuti. Second is bhasitam, another name bhasitam. Bhasma. Fourth name is kshar, and fifth name is raksha. 5 names are there for. Now when Bhagwan adorns his body with this bhasma, and when we meditate on this Lord, when we worship him, and we also apply that bhasma, what is the glory of that? But you, those who are pujakas, upasakas and all that, when they do, those are vibhuti word we had seen earlier. Vibhuti means Aishwarya Karanat. Lordship. Bhagwan's all might, prowess, knowledge, wealth, everything that which is indicated by that word Vibhuti. So the idea is those who are totally devoted to Lord Shiva, And when they also apply this vibhuti, they are also blessed with this Aishwarya. Second, bhasitam. Bhasitam Bhasitam, shining actually, bhasitam is shining, bhasanat bhasitam. It comes from the word bha, shining. You see, when you see certain metals, also when they become dirty, dusty, and you take even this bhasma also ash, and if you apply that, they start shining. I hope you have experimented. So just think, if a pot also can be shining with that, why not our mind? So it is said, this bhasitam is shining. Idea is, again, those who are devotees of Lord Shiva, because his vibhuti, his bhasma is not an ordinary one. And when you meditate, when you also that apply that, then you also shine, your personality also shines, and even physical body also starts shining. And we know that even those people who are living in very cold places, very snow and all that is there, you know, if they apply all that vibhuti bhasma all over the body, then they don't feel that much cold. I am afraid of cold, so therefore I don't go to such places. But vibhuti bhasma is there. So bhasitam is the second word. It shines your personality. Mind is purified, that is the meaning. Third word called bhasma. Bhasma, ashes, you know. Like something when you put in the fire, it is reduced to ashes. In the Bhagavad Gita, it said, Jnanagni sarva karmani bhasmasat kurute. The fire of knowledge burns all the karmas to ashes. So here also the idea is, when somebody is applying that ash on the body, that means this person has burnt all his karmas, a liberated one. Sarva aghabhakshanat bhasma. It is defined as, because it swallows, destroys all agham papam. Whatever karma is done, all punya pap karma, all are finished. Because even only punya karma remains, you have to go to heaven and all that. That's not liberation then. So Aishwarya Karanat Vibhutihi Bhasanat Bhasitam Sarva Aghabhakshanat Bhasma Bhasmi Karoti. And then another word is called Kshar. Kshara word comes from the verb kshara, ksharati, perishes. Akshara, imperishable. So what happens? Kshara yeti, all the karmas, apada, everything is finished. Apada means sankata, difficulties, problems, and all of them. And all the karmas are also finished. That's what it's called kshara. And last word is raksha. Raksha. The very word raksha also says rakshati, that which protects you. That's why there is one Sri Ram Raksha Stotram. Then there are so different Narayana Kavacham, and all these are called, they protect you. So, raksha. I remember some of childhood and all that, what used to do in one small katori, put some this bhasma vibhuti. And when you chant Ram Raksha Stotram, with your finger you just go on touching that, what you call that raksha. And when the stotra is over, then you put here. People also go to the temple and they also put on, because now it is not an ordinary raksha. Now it is abhimantrit. Now we have chanted, so the power of the Lord comes in that. And it protects you from bhuta, preta, samsara, bhiti, abhirakshati, abhibhiti, bhyaha. So that is called raksha. So these are the names we find in the Upanishad. There is one Brihadjhavala Upanishad in that, which is there. The meanings are given there. So this is called Veda Sara Shiva Stotram. So Bhagavan's Vibhuti. But Bhagavan Shankara, he takes Vibhuti even from the cremation ground also. Whatever he takes for everything become mangala only. We will be afraid of cremation ground and taking the vibhuti from there. If you go to the temple and all, then that is fine. Or when a yajna is also conducted, a homa, in the end also we take from there, you know, that raksha and all that. That is also very wonderful. But for Bhagavan, even smashana raksha also, bhasma also, is glory for him. And that also shows that he is beyond all the body identifications, body attachments. That's all that bhasma indicates, that when we apply to our body. So that's what called bhavam bhasvaram bhasmana bhushitangam bhavani kalatram bhaje panchavaktram. So all the karma nasha takes place, all papas are also gone, your personality shines forth, you get the aishwarya also, and it protects also, and therefore it is called bhasma. Acha. Bhaje panchavaktram. Now again panchavaktram, you see. See, earlier we saw panchavaktram in the form of panchakrutyam. That five aspects that Bhagavan has to do, that srishti, siti, samhara, nigraha and anugraha. So therefore they call panchavaktram. Now here it is a Vaidic. Bhagavans, these five vaktras are there. One mukham, one face, is facing the paschima direction, west, westward. And the name of that is Sadyojata. The name of that face is called Sadyojata. It's facing paschim. Then that which is facing northward, that is northward, is called Vamadeva. Vamadeva. Dakshina, southward, his name is Aghora. Aghora. Then Prak. Prak, that is Purvadisha, the eastward. That mouse name is Tatpurusha. And Urdhva, upward, Ishana. These are the Panchavaktras. Sadyojata, Vamadeva, Aghora, Tatpurusha and Ishana. See, in the Vedas, then there are the beautiful stutis of each one there, and prayer also that is there. So these mantras are chanted. In our here Jagdishwar Mandir also, every evening when we do the aarti, there also these mantras are chanted, these five. I will try to tell you briefly only. Immediately don't ask me where it is, give the transliteration, give the translations and give and all that. Please fill your heart with just love and devotion and just listen. Om sadyo jatam prapadyami sadyo jata yavai namo namaha bhave bhave nati bhave bhavasvama bhavod bhavaya namaha namaha. So the first namaha salutation to sadyo jata. What is the meaning of sadyo jata? Jata means born, appeared. Sadya means instantly. Today, or we call instantly, the one who appeared instantly, sadyo jata. Sadyo jatam prapadyami. I worship, I surrender, I take refuge in the sadyo jata Bhagavan, who is Lord Shiva only. His name is only sadyo jata. The sadyo jata, his westward face is called sadyo jata. Sadyo jatam prapadyami, sadyo jata yoi namo namaha. We salute the namaskar. Bhagavan said, "Acha, you are doing namaskar, what do you want?" So this very beautiful line, bhave bhave nati bhave bhavasvamam. Bhagavan, please guide me to what? See, the line is very interesting. Bhave bhave nati bhave. So one interpretation is, please Bhagavan, bhave bhave na, please don't put me in this samsara again and again. So many times I have come in a punarapi jananam maranam and all that. So please don't put me in this samsara again and again. Bhave bhave na. Then what do you want? Ati bhave. That which is beyond this samsara called moksha. In that you just guide me. Just push me there now. Bhave bhave na ati bhave. So bhave bhave na ati bhave maam. Acha. But you know, see, these some bhaktas are such, their devotion is such that, you know, they say bhave bhave na ati bhave. They say we don't want moksha also. Bhave bhave yatha bhakti padayostava jayate. One, you put me in this samsara, but on one condition. And that condition is, my heart must be filled with devotion for you. Then it's all right. But otherwise, only punarapi jananam maranam, what is that? We don't want that type of bhava bhava. So, idea here is, bless us with that. If your remembrance is there, whether we are in samsara or beyond samsara, we are liberated only. Sadyo jatam prapadyami sadyo jataya vai namo namaha bhave bhave nati bhave bhavasvamam. Bhagavan said, why are you asking me? Bhavod bhavaya namaha. Because you are the one from whom the whole samsara, whole jagat comes out. Bhava udbhava. See, the words are also beautiful. Bhave bhave nati bhave bhavasvamam bhavod bhavaya namaha. So if the samsara comes from you, you only can put an end to it also. That is the meaning. ये तो आपके चुटकी भर का काम है आपके. Then you can finish it just like that, you know. So therefore, this is prayer to Bhagavan's westward face. See, Bhagavan is facing all directions. So wherever you happen to be there, and whichever face you have in front of that, you can just pray that. You know. People go to Kailash, Mansaro, Yatra, so they are also, they do the pradakshina and all that. So therefore, there also they had to face, you know, different faces of Bhagavan. Sadyo jatam. Then, Vamadevaya namo. Next is Vamadevaya namo o Jeshtaya namo Shreshtaya namo Kalaya namo Rudraya first time. Vamadevaya Namo, O Jeshtaya Namo Shrestaya. I am not trying it correctly. Vamadevaya Namo, O Jeshtaya Namo Shrestaya Namo Rudraya Namo Kalaya Namo Kalavikaranaya Namo Balavikaranaya Namo Balaya Namo Balapramathanaya Namo Sarvabhutadamanaya Namo Manonmanaya Namaha. So this is the prayer to see what happens when we chant with everybody. It just comes just like that. हाँ, ये flow होता है ना. एक this is the beauty of the chorus. Chorus में यही होता है, उसमें रस होता है. वो यदि अकेला हो तो को रसा को रस कहाँ है. वामदेवाय नमो. अच्छा, भगवान नेम इज वामदेव एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड नॉर्थ वर्ड फेस. वामदेव मीन्स अत्यंत सुंदर. दैट्स कॉल्ड वाम. वाम वर्ड ऑल्सो यूज फॉर सुंदरता. एंड देवा ऑफकोर्स गॉड मोस्ट हैंडसम. दैट भगवान इज that Vamadevaya Namo. And then what that Vam Bhagwan, Vamadeva Bhagwan is? Namo O Jeshthaya Namo Shrestaya. Jeshtam is the eldest. Because Bhagwan is first, isn't it? As Sachidanswar, he is first. But even for the manifestation, he only comes first. And then all other things come. Therefore, he is the eldest. And sometimes, you know, a son may be eldest in the family, but may not be Shrestha, may not be great. But you know, Shrestha, the best, the perfect. So salutation, namaskar to Vamadeva Bhagwan, who is the firstborn, therefore Jeshta, Shrestha, the supreme. Namo Rudraya, Rudraya. Bhagavan's name is Rudra. Generally we say one form of Bhagavan Shiva is Shiva Rupa, Shanta, Saumya, gentle. And Rudra, the very word we say is Rudra. So appears as something fierce and all that. But the word Rudra also has got different meaning. One is called Rodayati, the one who makes you weep and cry. Oh, when, see, when the deluge time, destruction times and all that comes, people cry and weep, isn't it? Or when they have done papa karmas, and papa karmas are there, and then Rudra Bhagavan comes, so they are then frightened. Rudra. But one beautiful meaning also is there. Those who are devotees, their hearts are filled with love for God. When they think of Bhagavan, whether as Shiva or as a Rudra, a Shankara, whichever way, there all the tears of love start flowing. Because the heart is filled with that love. So bhaktanapi rodayati, dushtanapi rodayati. That's why it's called Rudra, Bhagavan, Rudra. Okay. Something more we'll see again. Vamadevaya Namo O Jeshtaya Namo Shrestaya Namo Rudraya Namo Kalaya. Kalatmaka Parameshwara. Kalaya. Kalam is time. I know, that's why Kalaya Tasmai Namaha, Kalaha Jagat Bhakshakaha. See, this time, you know, we do not see its movement at all. But moment to moment, everything is wearing out. Kshaya Karanat. Happening or not? Directly, we do not see Kala, time as such. Only the modifications and changes which take place in things and being, that becomes the indicator of that time. Otherwise, you know, it's a clock, watch, and all that tick, 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 tick. That is one thing. But with every tick, Bhagavan is playing a trick. And then we just don't know also. From my lifespan, 1 second gone. Everything is over. You buy anything, medicine also, expiry date. So as the day go by, this just power is going then. Any food items and everything like that. Kshaya. So they say, now don't keep it for longer time. It will be finished. Kalaya. Then it's called Kala Vikaranaya. So Kala Vikaran means what? In the medium of time, that which is unmanifest earlier, that becomes manifest. Then that also undergoes modification. Vikara takes place. So the time is that factor which causes all these modifications. And that Kala Shakti is of Paramatma only. That's why Bhagavan called Mahakal. Is one of the Jyotirlingas in Ujjain called Mahakaleshwar. So, Balavikaranaya, Kalaya Namaha, Kalavikaranaya Maha, Namo Balavikaranaya Namaha, and Balaya Namaha. Balayan Bhagavan is the source of all strength. And Balavikar means he has distributed that strength, you know, different people in different ways. See, there is a physical strength, right? We have got emotional, intellectual, spiritual, financial, and political power, and how many different kinds of power that are allotted to different people, and from Brahmaji, the creations to sustenance, dissolution, and then disciplining, and all that. So, all this bala delegated, these powers are also delegated. But he is the final source of all powers, and from that only everybody is going to getting it. We will find in the story of Hiranyakashipu and Prahlad also, that Hiranyakashipu asked Prahlad, on whose strength you are doing all these things? He said, the source of strength is only one. Isn't it? The Lord. Ravana asked Hanuman also, on whose strength you destroyed Ashokan? He said, there is only one source. Paramatma is the only source. Here, that Paramatma is indicated, Lord Shiva. So, Namo Balavikaranaya, Namaha Balaya Namaha, then Bala Pramathanaya. Pramatha means subduing, finishing. So, as when it is required, Bhagavan, that power comes and he says, enough is enough. Finish karo sabar. Matha means churning, Pramatha means just finishing now, enough now. Bala Pramathanaya Sarva Bhuta Damanaya Namaha. And he is the one who subdues all beings, disciplines all beings. And you know that time factor is that, you know, in our youth, we want to show off so much. And as the oldest, Angam Galitam Palitam Mundam. Oh, Takat Pele Jasin Nehre. Suddenly I saw, you know, when you buy a new toothpaste tube, you know, how it is full of all that, and then little, and then mash it. Aise haal hamara hota youth mein, sarva bhuta mein. In youth, everybody tried to show off and all that. Oh, okay, sab theek ho jayega abhi. Sarva bhuta damanaya, and the last is most beautiful, manonmanaya namaha. Bhagavan, you are the one, manaha unmanaya. You can raise my mind to the state of unmana. Unmani avastha is there, where the mind becomes no mind. माइंड इज मर्ज इन द परमात्मा. सैल्यूटेशन टू दैट वामदेव भगवान लॉर्ड शिव ही इज उत्तर वक्त वामदेवाय नमो ज्येष्ठाय नम श्रेष्ठाय नमो रुद्राय नमः कालाय नमः कल विकरणाय नमो बल विकरणाय नमो बलाय नमो नम सर्वभूत मनोकाल मनो प्रमथनास प्रमथ बल प्रमथाय एंड देन सर्वभूत दमनाय एंड मनोन्मनाय नमः. भगवान टेक आवर माइंड टू दी फ्रॉम टेरेस्ट्रियल टू दी ट्रांसेंडेंटल वर्ल्ड यू जस्ट टेक अस. दैट इज द मीनिंग. ओके अभी तीन और रह गए. हाँ टुमारो विल सी द अदर थ्री. See, there are so many, meanings and all that are there. But only I am just seeing the meaning as meant for prayer and to fill our heart with devotion. This is called Veda Sara Shiva Stotram. You understand? This is Veda Sara Shiva Stotram. ॐ नमः शिवाय 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 ॐ नमः शिवाय. उमापते महादेव की जय. श्री सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय. ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ओम शांति शांति शांति. हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः. हरि ओम.